Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. Say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jellin. Today, a question sent in by me. I have this data in Word, 23 pages of data, and I needed to sort it based on the name after the bullet point. Okay, and I kind of poked around in Word. There's something about sorting a table, nothing that would let me sort these two paragraphs together. So I just punted. I said, all right, this isn't going to work. I'm going to take the data. I copied the data from Word and pasted it all to one column in Excel. And this is what I ended up with. I ended up with the function name in bold, and then the next row has the description. Function name in bold, next row has the description. And I said, all right, we need to find a way to sort this. And because I'm looking for something in bold, I ended up saying, all right, well, what I need to do is write a little bit of VBA. So we'll switch over to VBA here and we'll talk about this. One-time use macro, so it's just going to be quick and dirty. We're going from row 3 to row 702. I'm going to hard code that in. We'll take a look in Visual Basic. And so here's a loop. It goes from 3 to 702. We have this loop variable, I. Each time through the loop, it's going to be pointing at a different row, in essence. Check to see if column 4, that's column D of this row, is equal to bold. And if it is, then I know that I have a function. And I go through a second little loop here to look for the opening parentheses and grab everything up to that point as the function. And then write that function out to both the row in bold and to the next row. I added an extra column here, column C, that gave me the style, if it was bold, function name, and if it was not bold, function description. That matches the styles that we have in Word. So function name and function description. That's what the copy editor set up for this data originally. So let's run this code. It'll just take a second to run here. And then when I go back to Excel, you'll see that I've now taken that function name, like ABS, and put it on both the function name and the description. So I'll add some headings in here. I'll call it function, and then style, and then original text. I'm always paranoid when I do this that something's going to go wrong. So I'm going to insert a new column here called sequence. The sequence column is just going to have the numbers 1 through whatever, 700. So that way, if something goes wrong, I can always sort back into the original sequence and get it right again. All right, so here's what I think I can do. I think I can simply sort by function. So we'll go to data, click the A to Z button. And there, that will take all of my data and sort it alphabetically by function. Something that would have been very hard to do in Word, but by using Excel. And you know, a couple of tricks here. This is a basically a common trick for when you have multiple logical records for one record. We're able to sort it. Now, my big problem is I need to get that data nicely formatted back into Word. Using the original styles in Word. That'll be tomorrow's podcast. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.